The first thing that we look at is to measure your breathlessness at rest and measure your upper tolerance of breathlessness. The second thing is the importance of nose breathing to improve arterial oxygen uptake. We also want to improve your tolerance to reduce oxygen and increase CO2. We want to show you to improve your aerobic capacity, increase EPO, and this is looking at the science, breath holding, the effect it has on running time, running economy and running time, delay the onset of lactic acid and fatigue, improve respiratory muscle strength. We give you a pre-match preparation, which is pretty revolutionary. I think we're the first ones to think about it, how to do it, to get the absolute utmost out of an individual pre-match. And we do a combination of relaxation, breath holding, hyperventilation, and then game. And it, you know, from a physiological point of view, of course the sequence hasn't been trialed, but it's an experiment, but physiologically it makes sense. Improve sleep. A lot of my work is with sleep. Last week or 2 weeks ago, I was in Hong Kong and I gave a 4-day training at Kowloon Hospital. It was attended by ENTs, physiotherapists, speech and language pathology. And before that, I spoke at the World Sleep Fair. That was in Prague. That was attended by 1,500 medical doctors. Breathing through the nose is key for sleep. Any of your athletes or any of you as instructors or individuals, if you are mouth breathing, you're not going to have a good night's sleep. That has been shown. So even just sleep alone is huge. That is an area just in itself. Exercise-induced asthma. My first 10 years of my work was working specifically with that. I've written 2 books that have been the best-selling, the top 10 best-selling asthma books in the world since 2005. There's a huge connection with the mind. Meditation is brilliant and following the breath is brilliant. However, we need to address breathing pattern disorders. Mindfulness doesn't address breathing pattern disorders. I was a mouth breather for 20 years. I was fast breathing for 20 years. And fast breathing agitates the mind. You cannot get a centered or a focused state of mind by breathing fast. And if we're breathing fast all the time, the mind is agitated all the time. So we're looking at the mind, asthma, sleep, pre-match. Yeah, and you could say, well, this is a miraculous thing altogether. Well, let's explore the science. Let's explore it.